is a major source of revenue for the regime.
A staggering more than $3 billion in stolen crypto over the past 5 years, U.S. lawmakers say. A record $1.7 billion last year alone.
So where does that money go? Straight into North Korea's illegal nuclear program.
An underground pipeline of illicit wealth, fueling Kim's nuclear ambitions. Pumping payments into Pyongyang from places like Russia, China, Hong Kong, Singapore, and Vietnam.
Does that pose a threat to our national security?
It does, sir. The U.S. believes North Korea has a global shadow army, secret operatives posing as IT professionals, government officials, freelance blockchain developers, even hiring Westerners to hide their connection to Pyongyang. Spanish police arrested Alejandro Caldevenos earlier this month, known as a special delegate for North Korea. The U.S. accuses him of helping North Korean officials use tech for money laundering. He posted a message on X, formerly known as Twitter, saying, "There is no extradition. The U.S. accusation, besides being false, does not exist in Spain." Blacklisted by the U.S. as modern-day digital pirates, North Korean operatives are linked to ransomware attacks, targeting online gaming, gambling, and banking industries. Even American hospitals, North Korea exploiting online vulnerabilities, using stolen money to mass-produce missiles, funding the Kim family's lavish lifestyle. Palaces, planes, yachts, and this armored Mercedes limousine carried on Kim's private train to that September summit with Russian President Vladimir Putin. The latest breach from North Korea's notorious Andariel hacking group, targeting South Korean defense firms and others. A year-long investigation by South Korean police and the FBI exposing grave vulnerabilities in Seoul's cybersecurity defenses. Around 250 sensitive files, 1.2 terabytes of classified data stolen. Crime concealed through rented servers, a secretive trail of digital deception leading straight to the North Korean capital, breaching borders, defying digital defenses, threatening global stability. Will Ripley, CNN.